U.S. senators have wrapped up their interrogation of Amy Coney Barrett at her Supreme Court confirmation hearings. And while members of the Senate Judiciary Committee pressed again for answers today, the nominee largely avoided committing herself. John Yang has our report.
On Capitol Hill, a final day of questioning for Supreme Court nominee Amy Coney Barrett.
Is there any...
Senators pressed Barrett on issues like voting rights, abortion, and the future of the Affordable Care Act, or ACA.
This hearing has been more about Obamacare than it has you.
The court is to hear a challenge to former President Barack Obama's health care law next month. Republicans pushed back against Democrats' arguments that Barrett would help a 6-3 conservative court overturn the ACA.
Democrats' strategy continues to be to use scare tactics, distortions, and speculation.
What's not fair, is it, to suggest that by confirming you to this position, you're somehow going to adversely impact the lives of these individuals?
Well, as I said yesterday, what I can say is that I have certainly no agenda. I'm not on a mission. I'm not hostile to the ACA at all. And if I were on the court and if a case involving the ACA came before me, I would approach it with an open mind, just like I do every case.
What we want to do is terminate it and give great health care.
18 Republican-led states in the Trump administration are challenging the law's individual coverage mandate. If the court agrees, the justices could strike down the entire law through a legal doctrine called severability, finding that the mandate is so central to the law that it cannot be severed from it.
If you picture severability being like a Jenga game, it's kind of, if you pull one out, can you pull it out while it all stands?
Committee Chairman Lindsey Graham of South Carolina sought to blunt Democrats' arguments that a Justice Barrett would mean the entire law would be doomed.
The main thing is the doctrine of severability has a presumption to save the statute if possible. Is that correct?
That is correct.
And would it be further true that if you can preserve a statute, you try to the extent possible?
That is true.
He especially sought to counter suggestions that Barrett would be an automatic vote to overturn the landmark case of Roe versus Wade, which guarantees the right to an abortion. As a law professor, she appeared to suggest it was wrongly decided.
Reaching a decision that the case was wrongly decided doesn't end the debate in terms of whether or not it should be repealed. Is that correct?
That is correct.
And there is a very rigorous process in place to overturn precedent?
There is, many factors, reliance being one.
Senator Kamala Harris, the Democratic vice presidential nominee, asked Barrett about voting rights and suppression.
My question, however, is do you agree with Chief Justice Roberts, who said voting discrimination still exists? No one doubts that. Do you agree with that statement?
Senator Harris, I will not comment on what any justice said in opinion, whether an opinion is right or wrong, or endorse that proposition. Senator, I'm not exactly sure what you're getting at with asking me to endorse the fact or whether any particular practice constitutes voter discrimination. I'm very happy to say that I think racial discrimination still exists in the United States, and I think we've seen evidence of that this summer. But as
do you
to engaging
that voting discrimination exists based Senator, on race in America in any form?
Senator Harris, and I don't mean to signal that I disagree with the statement either. What I mean to say is I'm not going to express an opinion because these are very charged issues. They have been litigated in the courts, and so I will not engage on that question.
Committee Democrats highlighted Barrett's refusal to say she would recuse herself from any case arising from a disputed presidential election. Barrett, along with current Justice Brett Kavanaugh and Chief Justice John Roberts, was among the lawyers dispatched to Florida to work for the Republicans in the 2000 recount. Senator Amy Klobuchar of Minnesota.
Well, having justices with this background, two of whom were appointed by the current president, decide any cases related to the upcoming election, do you think that will undermine the legitimacy of the court?
Asking whether something would undermine the legitimacy of the court or not seems to be trying to elicit a question about whether it would be appropriate for justices who participated in that litigation to sit on the case rather than recuse. And I went down that road yesterday saying it's a legal question.
You said you wouldn't recuse. That's why I thought it was
That isn't what I said.
Senator Patrick Leahy of Vermont asked Barrett about President Trump's claim that he could pardon himself.
Would you agree, first, that nobody is above the law?
I agree, no one is above the law.
Does a president have an absolute right to pardon himself for a crime?
So far as I know, that question has never been litigated. That question has never arisen. That question may or may not arise, but it's one that calls for a legal analysis of what the scope of the pardon power is.
With even Democrats speaking of Barrett as a future justice, the outcome of the hearings is largely a foregone conclusion.
Judge Barrett is going to be confirmed by this committee and by the full Senate.
Today, Graham said Barrett's nomination is a milestone for conservative women.
The first time in American history that we've nominated a woman who's unashamedly pro-life and embraces her faith without apology, and she's going to the court. When it comes to health.
Tomorrow, on the fourth and final scheduled day of hearings, senators will hear from legal scholars and other outside witnesses selected by committee Democrats and Republicans to weigh in on Barrett's nomination. For the PBS NewsHour, I'm John Yang.